So in today's video, we will be talking about the Intel HEX file format, and towards the end of the video, we will be learning how to calculate the checksum. Starting with the definition of the Intel HEX file. So basically, the Intel HEX file, it is an ASCII text-based file format which is used for representing binary data. It's mainly used in embedded systems and microcontrollers, and its purpose is to transfer the program code and the data to the microcontrollers and other embedded systems. If you look at a brief history of this file format, it was introduced by Intel in the 1970s, and ever since it has become an industry standard whenever it comes to firmware and microcontroller programming. Another type of HEX file format is the Motorola HEX file format, but in this video we'll be focusing on the Intel HEX file format. So this is the basic structure of an Intel HEX file format. This is a snippet of a complete Intel HEX file. We can see that there are a number of lines. Each of these lines is said to be a record. Now, coming to the syntax of each record, the Intel HEX file record is said to have 5 different fields, and each field is represented by a maximum of 2 letters, and each letter it stands for a hexadecimal digit. So in short, each field is made up of a minimum of 2 hexadecimal digits, hence each field represents 1 byte each. So as said, there are 5 different fields in the hex record, and every field it starts with a colon. And the first field, which is LL, it indicates the record length. It indicates the number of data bytes which will be present in the DD field. Next is AA, which indicates the starting address for the data. If it is a 16-bit processor, it indicates just the 16 bits. Else, it will indicate the upper 16 bits in case of 32-bit processors. The next field is the DT field, which indicates the type of the hex record. Based on the number present in this field, there are various types of hex records. The fourth field is the DD field, which indicates the data field. And the number of data bytes represented by the DD field should match the number which is specified in the LL field. And finally, we have the checksum field. This represents the checksum of the record, and it's especially useful for error detection. Now, based on the DD field, we have 6 main types of records. The first type is the data record, when the number is 00. The second one is the end of file record, when the number is 01. The third and fourth types are related to the segmented memory models, and when the number is 02 and 03 in the DD fields, it's respectively the extended segment address record and the start segment address record. And the fourth and the fifth types are the flat memory model related records, which are nothing but extended linear address record and start linear address records. Now, let us consider the example of the first hex record, which was displayed in the snippet of the hex file. In this case, the number is 03 followed by a number of zeros, 20, C1, F, and D0. And always each record starts with a colon. If we classify this number into the various fields, We can visualize it using this table. It starts with a colon, and then the first two digits, 03, it represents the length of the record. This indicates that the total number of data bytes should be 3. The next four digits, which are nothing but the four zeros, it indicates that the starting address for this data byte will be four zeros. The next field, which is the TT field, is again 00, and this indicates that this particular record is a data record. And the next field is the data field. It starts with 02, the first byte of data, 0c, the second byte of data, and 1f, the third byte of data. Hence, we have 3 bytes of data as indicated by the LL field. And finally, based on all the previous fields, the checksum is calculated and it is obtained as D0. Now, when we talk about the memory addressing, as indicated here, the starting address is 0000H, so that will be occupied by the first data byte, which is nothing but 02 in this case. Now, the subsequent data bytes, they will be allotted in such a way that the memory addressing is in contiguous manner. So the next byte of data, which is 0C, occupies 0001H, and the final byte of data, 1F, it occupies 0002H. Hence, each memory address is occupied by one byte of data. Now, talking about the calculation of checksum, first and foremost, we saw that the entire record is made up of hexadecimal digits, and each field should be represented by at least 2 hexadecimal digits. So the first step is, we are going to divide the entire hex record into hexadecimal pairs, and we are going to add each of these hexadecimal pairs up to the DD field. And the second step, whatever hex sum is obtained, we will convert that hex sum to decimal. For example, if the hex sum obtained is 49C, in this case we have 3 digits, and whenever this occurs, we will ignore the first digit MSB, so that always the resulting hex decimal, hex sum, is also only 2 bits. And this remaining 2 bits will then be converted to decimal. After we have obtained this decimal number, we will subtract it from 256, and that will be the third step. And whatever result is obtained in this step, it is converted back to hex number, and this will generate our required hex checksum. Considering this conversion with the help of an example, we are considering the same example but without the checksum mentioned. So it is 03 followed by zeros, 20 C1F. After dividing this hex record into hexadecimal pairs, we get 03 00 00 00 02 0C and 1F. All these hex pairs are first added, and it results in 30H. So that is our first step for calculating the checksum. In the second step, this hexadecimal sum is converted into decimal, and that gives us the number 48. In the third step, this decimal output is subtracted from 256, and the resulting decimal number is 208. When this decimal output is then converted into hexadecimal, we get D0, and this is our required checksum. We can append this to the hex record, and that in turn will give us the complete Intel hex record. So here the D0 has just been appended with the rest of the hexadecimal digits. In this case, we are considering another example in order to show the case wherein we get 3 digits in the sum of the hexadecimal pairs. So in this case, again, first we are splitting the given hex record into hexadecimal pairs, and once we sum all of it, we get 49BH. In this case, we have three digits, so we'll be ignoring the MSB, which is 4. And only 9B is considered for the decimal conversion. When 9B is converted, it is 155 in decimal output. The third step is again the same. We will subtract the obtained decimal output from 256. That results in 101. And finally, to obtain the checksum, this decimal output is converted into hexadecimal, and that gives us 65H. Once we append 65 to the rest of the hexadecimal digits in the Intel hex record, we get the complete hex record. So the previous two examples, they have been taken from the code snippet. In the case of this snippet of the hex file, it already had the checksum appended. So if you want to try for the numbers, exclude the last two digits, calculate it, and ensure that whatever result you obtained is the same as the last two digits present in this hex file. This slide and the various calculations are present in the description box as a PPT. You can also visit my blog to check the same. Thank you.